not too bad. Okay, so I'm coming here today. I've got to learn to look this direction. I'm here today because I decided a few days ago that I was going to try to make a wig for the first time with a closure. And here's the result of that. It's actually not too bad for a first time, but that could also be because I used curly hair. That was probably the best way to start out trying to make wigs was with curly hair, because curly hair can hide a multitude of mistakes. As far as the construction of this goes, I just looked at all kinds of different videos on YouTube, how other people make their wigs, and I just basically tried to use the same pattern as they did. I sewed in the closure. The closure is a 10 inch, which I really kind of wish I had gone with 12, but it's a 10 inch closure. Can't talk today. 10 inch closure by Sensationnel. It's their Sensationnel Bare Natural Peruvian Bohemian something. I'll leave a link down below. It's actually not bad, and I got it because it was the closest closure that I could find on the website that I bought it from that would go with this. And it's still not, it's not perfect, but it's close enough for me. The closure was only $19.99, I believe, so it's not like it was a, you know, a great stretch if I had completely messed this whole entire thing up. The rest of the hair is, I've actually had this hair before. It is by Sensationnel. It's the Premium 2 Mixx 4 in French Deep. And I'd had this hair before, and I'd used it to make clip-ins, and I liked the hair. And so I thought, you know, well, you know, if I'm going to make a wig, let me try it with hair that I'm already kind of familiar with. And again, because it was my first time making one, I didn't want to use expensive hair, because if I completely screwed it up, I would have been very, 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 very upset over the fact that I spent all this money, you know, on this expensive hair to make a wig that turned out horribly, horribly wrong. So, yeah, stick with cheaper beauty supply store hair. Because, again, I don't want to mess it up. So I, instead of sewing, like I sewed the closure, but for the rest of it, I used the a hot glue gun. And that was actually fairly easy, and that was good for me because it wasn't quite as time consuming. The only thing with that is sometimes getting big clumps of glue in places, and then, you know, you kind of pull it back and then you realize, oh crap, there's a big old chunk of glue just sitting right there and I can't do anything about it. So, you know, I won't be trying to pull this back anyway. It's just like right here. Of course it's in the front. Of course it is. Let me see. This hair, I actually like. It's the, I said what it is, but it is a blend between 100% human hair and their premium blend, and I don't know what they use for their premium blend. I don't know. All I know is that this works for me. You can brush it out just like any other curly hair to make it huge. The thing with this hair, and I noticed from the last time I bought it as well, is that even when you brush it out, give it about 30 minutes to an hour and it all clumps back together in its curls, or if you have it brushed out, like brushed all the way out, and you know, your hair is big, huge, and voluminous, as soon as you store it, you know, you put it away, when you pull it back out, the original curls will be back intact. So on the one hand, that's a good thing because you know that you're not going to lose that curl pattern, but on the other hand, it's not so great if you are intentionally trying to brush it out and wear it in a big poofy style, and then you go out and then like an hour or 2 hours later you look in the mirror and it's right back to where you were before. Carry a brush with you. if you're going to do that, carry a brush with you, because again, these curls do go right back to their original form. Let me see. With French Deep is an interesting one, because when I first bought it, I bought it from the beauty supply store. It was $26.99, I believe, when I first bought it. I decided I was going to go online to look for it, and I could only find two stores. I think they might have it on Amazon too, but only two stores that still carry it, and that was Ebony Line, which is where I bought it from, and I got it there for, how much did I get it for? $18.97. And then Hair to Beauty has it as well, I think for $19. So again, I bought this hair and the closure from Ebony Line, and that shipping was fast. It was really fast. Like, I ordered it in the middle of the night on a Thursday night, Friday morning. Woke up, it had already been shipped out. So you have Friday being shipped out. So you have Saturday, postal service doesn't run on Sunday. Monday, it was at my front door. I'm not mad at that at all. Especially when I really want something really, really quickly. So they get props from me for that one. Again, like I said, Hair to Beauty has it as well. But I'm kind of wondering if the company is discontinuing French Deep, because I went on Sensationnel's, their main website, to kind of check out all the different styles and patterns and stuff that they had, and French Deep wasn't listed on there at all. So I'm thinking they either phased this out or they renamed it something else. But yeah, I kind of like this hair. Well, not even kind of, I do like the hair. Trying to think what else. I use the spandex cap for this. I would strongly suggest that you not do that. I had the women's cap, and I already knew that there was going to be a little bit of extra room at the top because of what it showed on the front of the package. And because it, you know, it's, you have your top, but then there's like the little extra piece that kind of like sticks up right here. And when I put it on, I realized that my head is apparently not nearly as big as I thought it was. That thing was massive. It's gigantic. It's too much. So I think the next time I make one, I'm just going to use a regular dome cap. That one should be fine. Women's dome cap, men's dome cap. Either way, it's going to be smaller than the cap that I have on my head right now. I had to pin it down and fold big pieces of it over just so that I could continue gluing the tracks down. It was kind of a mess, and it kind of, I had to refigure everything just because of this stupid cap. So I won't be using that cap again. Again, I'll be using a dome cap next time. Is there anything else that I missed? I don't think so. I think that's pretty much everything on this wig. Again, I like it. Here's this side. I don't know if I can get to the back, but that's about as good as it's gonna get. Yeah, so it's, again, it's really not bad for a first try. I had to cut it down some. That's what it was. The 4-pack has a 10-inch, a 12-inch, no, a 10-inch, two 12-inches, a 14-inch bundle, and it actually comes with a teeny tiny little clip, like teeny tiny little closure that I could do absolutely nothing with, but I already knew that was going to happen because, again, I've bought this hair before. The 14-inch was actually way down here somewhere. And so, as you can see, I had to cut it. I cut it all the way up here. At first, I cut it to maybe about right here, and it still just, I could not get it to work with the rest of the hair the way that I wanted it to. So I had to cut quite a few inches off to make it work. So just be a little bit conscious of that if you decide to try this pack. Your 14-inch will hang a lot longer than the rest. And I mean, that should be a given anyway. because, you know, you're layering, but it was just, there was such a huge difference between the 12, this is the 12, and again, the 14 unstretched hung down all the way down here somewhere. It was just, yes, yeah, it was a little special. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I think that's it. If I remember anything else, I'll put it in the description box below. I'll also put the links to both the closure and the hair on Ebony Line. I'll put those links in the box below as well. I can't talk today. And I'll also put the link for the French Deep from hairtobeauty.com down in the description box as well. So yeah, that's about it. My first wig. Oh yeah, and the closure is just a straight, it's just the one part. Can't really do too much with it for the rest of it. So yeah, that's it. That's all. This is longer than I intended for it to be. So I hope that everybody's having a good day. If you've tried this type of hair before, or you have some like extra special tips on how to make these wigs, please leave them in the comment section below. I would love to hear what you have to say. Yeah, I think that's about it. Yeah, all right, y'all have a great day.